Hi, welcome back to the channel. What you are seeing right now was created by an AI. That's right, this is a video about AI. Yes, another one. No, there aren't enough of those on YouTube yet. You guys ask me a lot about how to get your own animated avatar to use in your videos. Well, there's a new way to do it. You guessed it, it's with AI. Let's have a look if it's worth a try for what I want to achieve.
Wow. I mean, I don't even know what to say. That's very convincing, don't you think? I mean, what is there to do for me now? I mean, all this new AI thing is making the rounds now, but especially with Adobe Character Animator, the program I use for animation a lot, basically wouldn't exist if it wasn't for AI. So we've already been using it. It's just making a big leap right now. Especially in 2D animation, as you could see just a second ago. No, I'm just kidding, of course. In my case, with what I do, I think it's kind of different because everyone on the internet is right now using AI to not go to the trouble to have actual ideas and asking AI to have ideas for them. And I'm really not interested in that. And I want to draw a character and I want to be able to feed it to the AI and actually ask the AI to help me animate it. So, as my little convincing companion said earlier, you guys asked me a lot about this talking avatar I have here and how you can get one of your own to use it in your own videos. To that regard, I thought I would look into what AI can do for us to achieve that kind of goal. And of course, beyond that, maybe later, help us with more complicated animations, because the kind of animations I do have to do a lot of frame-by-frame animations for the gestures and all sorts of things. And I really wish there was a way I didn't have to do that. I thought, okay, let's look into some of the solutions that might work. And here they are. So the first one I want to look at is actually built into Adobe Character Animator. That's the program I use all the time for animation, as some of you know. And you can actually go inside of Character Animator, you open a new project, and you go to File, Open Characterizer, and then it will ask you to actually line up your face and do some expressions and say some things to actually kind of train the AI what your expressions are. And then you can load in your artwork. I did that here, and line up all those guides here so the AI will know where the mouth is and where the eyes are. Then it will prompt you with a mask panel where you can mask out all the elements of the face, so it knows that. And then as you can see, it's very convincing. It does a really great job, not. And this is clearly, for me, it's not a solution. And here you can already see a problem that AI has all the time with animation or with video in general, it's consistency. It will always kind of flicker like this. But you can use this, I mean, if you have different styles, or you can actually use the styles that it provides inside of Characterizer. There are some templates there that work a little bit better. Everything that is kind of reduced like my style, like this cell shading that I have with a consistent outline thickness and everything, it will just mess everything up. The next one that looked kind of interesting to me is called DID or DID Studio, I don't know. And mostly it's for like presenter videos and has some actor trained models in there, but you can also upload your own image and hope that this thing will recognize the face in the drawing. For me, it didn't work out. I uploaded the avatar I'm using here and it told me that it didn't recognize the face. So I saw people doing this successfully, but most likely this is due to the simplicity of my illustrations that it didn't detect anything. So I was only left with the prompt up there. Put in a prompt that tries to narrow down on how I look, and then maybe it will give me something. And then we'll generate like suggestions for you. I don't know why it's black and white here. I really don't have a clue. Some of them are kind of blurry and sometimes it doesn't detect the face. But I kept trying and at some point I got some results I was willing to work with. this was, of course, not what I was looking for. And then I put in a text. You can actually use your own recording or generate an AI voice. And then it will generate the video for you. And this is what it looks like now. Here you can see it has a little bit more consistency, but it's clearly kind of a deepfake technology. Here's another example. And I think it works better with more realistic faces. And as soon as it gets too stylized and too cartoony, it will just break. So this was also not satisfying for me. But same thing here, you could actually maybe use it for yourself if you have a different style. So maybe it will recognize the face you drew, or you can actually use some of their generated faces. The last one is actually called Tokkingheads, and that's the one that is the easiest to use. You can actually connect with your Google account and get a free trial and get rid of the watermark in it, which I did. And you can also upload your artwork like in the other ones and then type in some text, choose a AI voice or upload your own voice. And here you can see it's doing the best job of all of them so far, but it's absolutely not what I'm looking for. It's also kind of doing a lot of guesswork around the mouth. It's using blur in those cases where it doesn't really know what to do. You won't see this so much if you used a photorealistic image, or it wouldn't do that so much because there would be more information it could work with. So what's my conclusion? I mean, basically I can say there's nothing there yet I would really seriously use. I know how it's supposed to look. I don't need an AI to tell me how my character is supposed to look or how my scene is supposed to look. I know how that looks. But mainly I want an AI that's very specialized in doing frame-by-frame animation or 2D animation. And I think what you can also see, especially in the last example, I think, it's mimicking human motion. And animation is not about human motion. I mean, it is about human motion, but it's very reduced. Everything in 2D animation is very deliberate. Everything is there for a reason or not there for a reason. And I think that's very hard to know because an AI is very generic and very broad. Yeah. And these decisions we make when we do 2D animation, they have very individual reasons. And an AI, as of now, is not very individual. What it already must be able to do is this kind of thing, I don't know if you know, Scanner Darkly or Waking Life, or there's also a new one by the guys who made BoJack Horseman. It's on Amazon Prime. It's like a rotoscoping cartoony style where you actually shoot a movie and then you trace everything over. And I think this stuff looks, some of it really looks like it does exactly that. Yeah. Like it's mimicking humans and their motion. Most likely while I'm talking here, there are already new AI solutions out there. So if you know something that is more up to the task, yeah, feel free to tell me in the comments. I would love to look into it and maybe even talk about it in a video. And you should check out my Gumroad page if you want one of my puppets. See you next time.
Yeah. Dear son, I'm spitting this before you fresh out. If I said I was blessed before, man, let's get in depth now. Yo. Give me a sec, yo. I gotta step out. Hold the on, moment we saw the ultrasound, my heart skipped a step. Wow. The beauty of...